勇者を死ね。
What's up guys, IntenseSense here. Welcome back to another episode of Ninja Voltage. So now this video was being requested a lot. I mean, in the live streams and other videos, I got like at least 2-3 comments. And this video took a lot of effort, so I needed some time to make it. So I would really appreciate if you give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Now before I start this video, do keep in mind there is no such thing as undefeatable or best fortress. I'll only show you how to make your own fortress and give some tips in between. You can copy this fortress as it is, but I will suggest you to take inspiration from this fortress and make your own changes according to your defense replays. Also, the layout of the fortress play 40% role, 40-45% role, and the other 60% is dependent on how good are your shinobis. So that's why I will use my second account, which is very average, because if I use my main account, it's not gonna be fair because I have all A rank shinobis and top shinobis in that. So now things are clear, let's get started. So the first step what you need to do is purchase all the fortress terrains with your Ryo. Why? Because then only you will have all the traps and installations available. If you don't purchase all the terrains, then you will have less number of bear traps or Nero traps and stuff. So once you buy all the fortress terrains, the second step is to choose the terrain of your fortress. Now there are only a few good terrains. Choose the one which will make the enemy to cover every single room so that the fortress itself eats some time. My best selection would be a layout in which if the supports get separated, the main shinobi will have to go 2 or 3 rooms to save them. The ones with this kind of setup are 17, 20 and 25. So I'm gonna go with terrain 20 since I have been using this for almost a year now and it works good. Now this terrain has been selected, so we clear all the installations. Now the third step is to choose the fortress appearance. So the best as of now is the ice layout because it has some good hiding spots and the trees make it difficult to look for installations. Now the basic steps are done. Now we have total 10 rooms which will have 5 defender rooms and 4 trap rooms and also a final room. First we will cover the empty rooms which will have tornado traps and installations. So the very beginning of the fortress, the first room. This is the place where you have to separate at least one support by using level 3 tornado traps. I mean, you have to try that at least one support gets separated. Also, this room, the main shinobi is definitely gonna use his trap clear jutsu. So put a chakra eating installation so that it guarantees CP loss. On the left side, put a tornado trap and a seal. Now we will put an aroma at the corner and between that another tornado trap. So that when enemy uses trap clear, it gets enabled and supports run towards it and get separated. So the first room is done. Now the second room. In this room we put 3 aromas followed by tornado traps and seal. Now KLM might use roar to destroy them, but a lot of times before that happens, other supports run towards the aroma and end up getting separated. Now we will use the same strategy as before, that the tornado traps have some distance between them. So you can decide the tornado traps position as you wish. I keep changing it when I find something wrong in the replays. Now coming on to the third room on the left, it's also gonna have a combination of aroma and tornado traps. Put it at a place where the supports might stand, and even if the main shinobi tries to destroy the aroma with Yata mirror, on his way back he might fly to a different room making the supports vulnerable. So distribute the tornado traps accordingly and put the aromas at a distance so that the supports run towards it and get separated. Now the fourth room on the right, it's time to eat some more CP. You can use the new CP eating installation which pops up with trap clear, which I only have one in this account because I already used in the first room. So you can also use the old CP eating installation along with some tornado traps and aromas. I am putting the tornado traps in front of installation because support or main shinobi will run towards it and end up getting separated. Now put one tornado trap in the corner and it's done. Now if you use the new installation, the trap clearing, it's highly recommended you put the tornado trap somewhere else in the room, not in the front, because the trap clear will reveal them. If the opponent reaches till here, he's sure to lose 600-800 CP, which is a lot. So the trap rooms are done. We are now to the shinobi rooms. So we start by how and where to put the revival pod. So if you haven't already purchased it from the fortress metal shop, do it now, it's very useful. The best location to put the revival is in front of final room. That way teleports cannot skip it and the enemy cannot gate crash without defeating it first. So put the revival pod in the corner so that either enemy has to summon it from far or go close to it. And on the way, put some seals, level wall tornado traps, and the mirror, which is very useful. Also put a beer trap or seal here, so that if someone comes flying, they land on it and get sealed and Gaara starts its combo. So the best option to put here is Gaara version 2. Even if you don't have his ultimate, it's perfectly fine. Just give him decent attack and defense. You can try adjusting the traps according to your defense replays. Watch the replays and figure out the mistakes. For revival, you wanna put a shinobi who eats a lot of time and chakra. Gaara version 2 is the best. If you don't have him, if you don't have his jutsus, then you can use Shisui. Now the bottom left and the bottom right room are the best to put your genjutsu trap behind a tree so that it's not visible. Now these two rooms must have high damaging defenders like Kankuro, Six Path Naruto, Jubito, Kabuto, any other red shinobi you have who does a lot of damage. Because the supports are likely gonna fall in this room. So if you put a genjutsu in either of these rooms, you're gonna lose a lot of capacity. So I would suggest to put the genjutsu in the left room and the shinobi in the center. So no matter where the supports fall, our defender will get summoned and start the combo. Now we have some capacity left, so put a wall at the entrance, because if somehow the main enters through the room and uses Yata mirror or something, it will get blocked and your shinobi will get summoned and the genjutsu trap will do its work. Also put a white aroma which increases attack and defense of your defender. Now bottom right. So since we already used our genjutsu trap, we are gonna have to manage without it in this room. So first of all, put the shinobi in the corner so that to summon it, they have to come close or at least use trap clear jutsu. So we put some level 1 tornado traps on the way so that the main or support shinobis fly within the room. Now since we want them to land in front of shinobi, we limit the empty area by using some walls so that the area that's left to fall is right in front of shinobi, where we will put some seals. Now also put aroma hidden behind tree to give that extra attack and defense. Now we go to the top right room. So this is an open room, so it's better if you put a shinobi whose jutsus are long range like Jubito, Rene Sasuke, Edo Itachi, etc. And we put some walls on the left and right in the entrance, and in the middle we put some beer traps and seal. Now near the shinobi, put an aroma. Also put an aroma in the corner to distract the supports or main shinobi hit marker. Put some level 1 tornado traps as well with some mirrors. Put the shinobi somewhat close to the gate so that as soon as the enemy enters, the shinobi gets summoned. Now we go to the top left room. In this, we use some beer traps on the entrance, followed by some aromas, seals, along with a good defender who has a good combo like Indra, Tobi Rama, Kankuro. Keep the defender close to the gate so when the enemy enters, they get stuck in beer trap and the defender starts the combo. Also, if someone comes flying, they are likely to fall in the empty area here, which will make them run towards the gate and they will get stuck in the spear traps. And the defender will start his combo as well. So now the defense has been set up. All that left is final room. So you wanna use shinobis with multiple iframes like EMS, KLM, Hokage Naruto, Edo Itachi, Madara, etc. Also if you have Rin, use her invincibility ultimate, it's really awesome. Because they just need to survive the ultimate. And KLM and Rin most of the time survive. Even if you have 2 star roar, that's perfectly fine, it will work. Now one more thing that's really important is the ordering of your shinobi jutsus. What I mean by that is that if you put the KLM roar as second jutsu, then most of the time he is not gonna use his roar as soon as someone enters the room. So set up all your defender's jutsus such that the combo starts great. Another example is Gaara version 2. Use the quicksand manipulation first, followed by the seal, then the 4 star. The jutsu on the bottom is the first jutsu. Now if you have trouble deciding which shinobi to use in defense or which shinobi to use in final room, you can watch my ranking video playlist, which will be coming at the top right now. Or visit the Reddit tier list, I will put a link in the description, which will help you decide what shinobis you have are good for defense, final room, etc. Now guys, that's it for the fortress defense video. Now I don't guarantee anything, especially in TAM. You might not win as much, but this will work somehow during normal attack missions. As I said earlier, the fortress layout is 40% responsible, rest 60% depends on your shinobis. If you want to copy, go for it, but I would strongly recommend that you make changes based on your defense replays. Also watch replays and see what's lacking where and adjust the layout accordingly. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. It took a lot of time for me to make this, so hit that like button and comment down below what do you think of this video. Also, if you are new, click on the red subscribe button and notification bell so that you can keep getting more helpful videos in the future. Follow my social medias, links are in the description. I'll see you next time. Sayonara.